might think this is my belated Halloween episode here on Jamie's Vinyl Hideaway, but tonight I'm doing a tribute to Boris Karloff. Boris Karloff's birthday is coming up soon, and he was born on November 23rd, 1887 in Surrey, England. And believe it or not, Boris Karloff is on vinyl. So this is our Boris Karloff on vinyl celebration. Now, Boris did the show Arsenic and Old Lace in 1941. And this is a recording of him in the show. I thought maybe it was a radio broadcast, but I think it's actually the show, Arsenic and Old Lace. And on the flip side is Bela Lugosi doing The Doctor Prescribed Death. This, of course, was Edgar Winter Group doing Frankenstein. I thought that might be a good introduction. This was Edgar Winter's follow-up to the Roadwork White Trash album. And this was a very successful album he did in 1973, I believe it was. So the first thing I want to play for you is a little something from a Radiola LP. Radiola from Sandy Hook, Connecticut. They also had a record label called Sandy Hook. And they re-released a lot of radio broadcasts. And this is going to be Boris in the Inner Sanctum. I'm just going to actually put the introduction on so you get an idea what it sounds like. Boris did a lot of radio programs in the 30s and 40s, like most Hollywood actors and actresses.
Lipton Tea and Lipton Soup present Inner Sanctum Mysteries, starring Boris Karloff.
Inner Sanctum was on CBS radio. There's a cool little picture of Boris here recording for NBC radio. I'm not sure what this picture's from. I was trying to find a movie that went with this picture. If anybody knows, please make a comment on my YouTube channel.
Are you stumped?
Hilarious people. Friends, are you looking for an apartment?
They always had these... kind of like a Svengoolie kind of guy of the radio days, you know? They would introduce the programs in a kind of tongue-in-cheek kind of way a lot. But anyway, when you think of Boris Karloff, I'm sure you think of show tunes, right? Now, I've never played a show tune on Jamie's Vinyl Hideaway. This will be my first show tune. 1950, Boris Karloff was in Peter Pan. He played Darling the Father.
Of course he was.
And he also played, of course, Captain Hook. And I've got a little reissue here on Columbia Special Products. And we're going to play the Pirate Song. Now, like I said, when you think show tunes, you think Boris Karloff, right? Because the man, of course you don't, but the... he sang. Everybody sings. So let's see if I can find the beginning here. The Boris Karloff singing the pirate song with the other pirates.
The pirates.
Here it is.
Enough. Enough of this bickering stuff. When I am around, there's no question of who is the meanest, the lowest, the lonesomest, cruelest. Look, it's Hook!
I'm Captain Hook!
Eat blood! Drink blood! Think blood!
Is he saying drink blood? I thought it was drink up, but it sounds like blood to me.
I heard blood.
Drink blood.
Drink blood.
Drink blood. Drink blood.
a sick one.
Captain Hook, Boris Karloff, 1950. This is an original one on Columbia Special Products label. Green Columbia Special Products label. You might have seen classical music and shows.
I want you to comb every inch of this island for those boys. Above all, I want their captain, Peter Pan, and a keg of rum for the man that brings him in.
Now, what's this? What do we got here? We have a Stump to Jamie. Stump to Jamie, number one. Let's see. Do I need my glasses? Well, it's written nice and big and bold. Here we go. When did Boris get his first starring role, and how old was he? Wow. First starring role.
We'll go with the age. How old was he? Make it easy for you.
Oh, well, it depends on what the first starring role really was. Okay. I mean, he was in a lot of movies prior to 1931's Frankenstein. That made him a star at age 44. But 44. He became a star at 44. But he had some roles earlier before that. And he was in silent films. The Bells was a silent film he did. But now I don't know when his first starring role was. But if you know, please make a comment on this Facebook. No, it's a YouTube channel, isn't it? Yeah, Facebook, that's something else. We're not going to talk about that.
Technology.
But anyhow, Boris Karloff on vinyl. In the 50s and 60s, Boris Karloff did a lot of children's records. I mean a lot of children's records. Telling stories. Like this little 10-inch of Peter Wolf.
Telling terrifying stories.
Terrifying to children. Stories. Like Peter Wolf.
Peter and the Wolf.
10-inch...
Dude.
What label was this? Mercury. Oh, Mercury's Child Craft Records. And there was an album, a couple albums he did called The Frightened in 1963. Came out on Mercury Records. And I'm just going to play a little bit of something like that. There's a hole right through the vinyl on both of these records. They cut it right through the cover, right through the vinyl. I have a few of them that do that, right through the label. So it doesn't affect the play. I'm not sure why they did that. I thought maybe a cutout when they were trying to sell them cheap. This is kind of how this sounded. The Frightened. These are the little stories that are on these two albums. The Man in the Raincoat, The Deadly Dress, The Hand of Fate. A little more adult, not for real little kids. Now, when I was a little kid, we had this record. And I'm not sure, and I've ever actually saw the cover when I was a kid. There's another later version of this as a different cover.
Floating.
This is Tales of Mystery and Imagination, Boris Karloff narrating The Legend of Sleepy Hollow and Rip Van Winkle on Cricket Records. Now, I had this before I even knew who Boris Karloff was when I was a little kid, and I really liked The Legend of Sleepy Hollow. Not so much Rip Van Winkle. There was no Headless Horseman in that, you know. Why do a show on Boris Karloff, you ask? I thought this was Jamie's Vinyl Hideaway. Well, I'm kind of mixing two loves. The love of the old monster movies, which led me to Boris Karloff, and my love for vinyl. So Boris did a lot of other children's records. How do you say that? Cademan C-A-E-D-M-O-N. I thought it was Camden, but Camon. Can you help? You know, pronunciation?
I'm not going to.
C-A-E-D-M-O-N. Records.
Cardamom.
One of those New York labels.
It's a spice.
Anyway, The Ugly Duckling, Jungle Books of Rudyard Kipling.
Rudyard. That guy.
Rudyard Kipling. Rudyard.
Let's not be so fanatic.
Anyway, he must have did
potato,
like a dozen
potato.
Of all of these nice little children's.
I love those covers, by the way. Look at that cover.
Well, at least we got Boris's picture on the back of one of them. Yeah.
I like the elephants.
That is a nice one. You know, some of them aren't as attractive, but I have two of them.
Could say that about people, but we don't.
No, we wouldn't say that about people.
No.
But anyhow, that's a whoa. There's another stump to Jamie. Let me secure the vinyl. Secure the vinyl, folks. No matter what you do, secure the vinyl before making any false moves. Oh, here it is. 1963, Mercury Records, The Frightened. Stump to Jamie, number two. Here we go. Whoa.
I'm fly fishing. This is hard.
Why is this so difficult? All right, here we go. Boris played the mummy. What was the mummy's... Oh, Imhotep.
Yeah.
Imhotep. What was the mummy's given name? I love the scene where Boris... The people from the museum are introducing themselves, and they go to shake Boris Karloff's hand because he comes back as the mummy, but he looks kind of human. And he won't shake their hand because he's actually dead, right? You know, he's like an Eastern prejudiced. I don't shake hands. Which leads me to believe to an evening with Boris Karloff and friends. This is a really cool record that came out in 1967 on Brunswick Records, where Boris talks about the movies he was in and the other great monster movies of the time, of the era that he was involved with. He mentions Dracula. Of course, he wasn't in that. Frankenstein, The Mummy. Bride of Frankenstein, Son of Frankenstein, The Wolfman, House of Frankenstein, all those great universal horror pictures. And he's going to talk about Frankenstein, the movie that changed his life, I guess, made him a star. We played the Frankenstein monster in three movies, the first one being Frankenstein in 1931. So let's see if I could find where I wanted to start this. But he starts talking about Frankenstein.
Made by the late and venerable Edward Van Sloan, who passed away not...
All right, we'll back up just a minute. We'll let him talk about...
I had hoped. How I came to be built is graphically described in this dramatic scene in which you will hear the voices of three fine actors. Dr. Henry Frankenstein, portrayed by Colin Clive, who died in the late 30s. Dwight Fry, who played in Dracula as well and died in the mid-40s. And Dr. Waldman, played by the late and venerable Edward Van Sloan, who passed away not too long ago in his 82nd year.
Yeah.
Of course, he mentions Dwight Fry, which we talked about on my very first Jamie's Vinyl Hideaway. With the Alice Cooper song, The Ballad of Dwight Fry. Ooh.
The storm will be magnificent. All the electrical secrets of heaven. And this time we're ready. Hey, Fritz. Ready.
Oh. Why, what's the matter?
Look!
Around the same time, Boris did a Christmas album for the United States Air Force.
Of course he did.
And he did a little song, a little story about Timmy Discovers Christmas. See, I mean, he was just like a sweet old guy at this point. He was always a sweet guy, but this was a couple years after he did The Grinch Who Stole Christmas, which at the time I didn't recognize. That's Boris talking, narrating how the Grinch stole Christmas. But I became a big Boris fan later on in life, after moving from Dracula to Wolfman and finally settled with the Frankenstein monster. It mentions in here that Boris's daughter, Sarah Karloff, was married to a man who was in the Air Force at this time when this record was being made.
They had the same birthday.
There's also a Nancy Wilson song on this.
Did you know that fun fact? They had the same birthday.
Sarah and Boris?
Yes.
Had the same birthday, November 23rd.
Yes.
And you really believe that you can bring life?
A little extra music added in here. But what I really want to get to is the Kenneth Strickfadden effects before we come to the close of this episode. Kenneth Strickfadden did all the electronics and all the gadgets that would make all the sparks and stuff, which I think led me to a career in electronics. I'll go with that.
Who are we to argue?
Tony for 1956.
From a creature put together from bits.
1956? Well, that would be after Arsenic and Old Lace and after Peter Pan, long after. Yeah, it's a drama. He played a priest. Oh, I could see the picture of him, like a cardinal. Oh, the something.
Another bird.
The word, you know, like a, he was, oh man, like a crucible kind of word, but not that, you know.
No, a bird.
A bird? Well, a bird.
Mm-hmm.
The cardinal. No, the cardinal.
No, not that bird.
It wasn't the raven. There was no show the raven. But, it was like if you know the answer to this question, please just put it on that YouTube page and remind me, because I am going to go look it up. And
stumped.
And I'm stumped.
Two out of three, stumped.
Two out of three, Jamie's stumped. Because I had never seen that show.
You owe me $10.
I don't see it. I've never seen it. No, because it wasn't a musical. It was like a drama. 1956.
What a terrible curse.
What's a little mummy there? Anyhow, that was my Boris Karloff birthday celebration. And I'll be moving back to, you know, rock and roll and music in my next episode, which I don't know what it's going to be. If you have any suggestions, please let me know. I do have a few things in the works coming up. So until then, later, man. Move it.